Hut, hut, hut.
I'm Chris White, sports editor of the Athens Banner-Herald and online athens.com, and this is Georgia beat writer Marc Weiszer. Marc, finally, this has been kind of speculation since the beginning of the season who would meet in this game, the SEC championship. It's Georgia and Alabama. The winner is just a technicality away from playing in the BCS championship game here, so obviously high stakes. What can you say about the magnitude of this game? I mean, the SEC has sent so many teams to the BCS championship, and these teams know they're in position that if they win, it would be some really bizarre miracle for them not to get into that game. What can you say about the weight that the players and coaches are putting on this week, knowing that?
Yeah, I mean, I think they're trying to kind of manage the weight of the game, not let it overwhelm them, especially as they practice Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. They always talk about not wanting to peak too high during the week, save it all for Saturday. But, clearly this is unlike any other of the five trips that Georgia has gone to the SEC title game under Mark Richt. Where you win the game and you know you're going to Miami, you're playing Notre Dame, you're a win away from the BCS title. They don't need help or huge upsets for anything to happen. It's all in their hands. So it's definitely, probably the most momentous game in 30 years for the program.
Yeah, and what about Aaron Murray? I know that's been a big topic this week. Usually he's a pretty accessible guy, does a lot of interviews, especially on Tuesday. He comes out and talks to the media for a long time until we run out of questions to ask him, it seems like. But this week he took off from the media starting after the Georgia Tech game. What do you think is behind that? Just kind of a focus thing, a schoolwork thing, or maybe he's trying to get out of a routine where he hasn't, maybe he's looking at, someone suggested that he's looking at things he's done during weeks where he hasn't played well in big games, and now he's trying to kind of get out of that routine and try something different?
Yeah, I mean, I think all those possibilities are legit. I mean, he might not want to answer the questions that he faced during the Florida week, which is, can you perform well at a big game? That week it was probably more about can you win a big game, and Georgia did win that game, but Murray had three picks in the first half, and clearly his statistics, weren't what he would like, and he didn't play well against South Carolina, another ranked opponent. So, whether it was spending 10 minutes on the teleconference the SEC set up this week or 20 minutes with the Georgia beat writers on Tuesday, Murray just decided he wasn't going to do any of that. And I know he had a couple of big exams, and he spent time in the film room a lot again. So we'll see if that pays off. Whether he performs well or not, I'm not sure if you can chop it up to his preparation, blowing off the media or being excused from the media.
Sure. And what can you say about the intricacies of this game? I mean, the teams haven't played since, I think, 2008, but got a lot of coaching ties, coaching parallels. I mean, everything from Georgia's defensive coordinator, Todd Grantham, having worked with Nick Saban at Michigan State, to Mike Bobo, offensive coordinator at Georgia, and Kirby Smart, a former Georgia player, close friends, now he's defensive coordinator at Alabama, and even Georgia offensive line coach Will Friend was a former Alabama player. Seems to be a lot of ties between these two teams, even if they haven't met very often.
Yeah, it just adds some more elements to what's already a fascinating matchup. Will Friend got a text message from one of his old Alabama offensive line buddies kind of saying he was torn about, which team to root for this week. And, when we talked to Will this week, he kind of blew it off from the standpoint of saying that, why you want to talk to a bad player from 20 years ago, even though he was a two-time All-SEC guy. I didn't want to really relive that. Bobo and Kirby are the best of friends. They go at it on the recruiting trail, whether they haven't faced each other since 98, but it'll be, 2008, but it'll be interesting to see how that dynamic plays out, that chess match. And then Grantham, obviously, a big influence Nick Saban was on his career. They worked together 3 years in Michigan State, as you mentioned, and both of them have two of the best defenses around now.
Yeah, and I've heard a lot of people talk about, what the key matchups are going to be, what, this team has to do this, the Alabama secondary, and Alabama has to do this to succeed against Georgia's defense. What do you think, what's your analysis of the keys for the game?
I mean, I think one of the keys is that Aaron Murray, needs to be the better quarterback. Both the quarterbacks in this game are efficient. McCarron for Alabama has two interceptions on the season, and Murray had three in the first half against Florida, although he's been, pretty much flawless in the month of November with 13 touchdowns and no interceptions. Let's see if that can carry over against, maybe the best defense he's faced all season. And I think, both battles of the line, the offensive line, the defensive line on both sides is going to be huge. Alabama's got, NFL caliber players on their line with 155 career starts, and Georgia's run defense has been very good, down the stretch. They played triple option teams, so the numbers were inflated. But will it turn out to be something like Kentucky, where they ran for 200 yards? Which Georgia defense shows up in that regard? And, you know, Georgia's going to have a big test. The other way, we're protecting Murray and, you know, being able to give him the pocket that they need to open up holes as well for Gershel.
Again, I'm Chris White, sports editor of the Athens Banner-Herald and onlineathens.com, and this is Georgia beat writer Marc Weiszer. You can find all of our stuff at onlineathens.com and dogbitesonline.com, as well as our Game Day iPad magazine. So if you've got an iPad, head to the iTunes store and search Game Day, and you can find that. It'll be out Friday morning. It's got all the stories from our Game Day, player stats, a look at dogs in the NFL, all that good stuff, and some videos that aren't on our website as well. So check that out. Thanks.